submits. Now the earlier concern was when the raised deed is registered, then you automatically respected the issues of the member.
Whatever.
Again, now the question arises, the nomination is also there. Apart from them, when such short term, at the most you are giving a newspaper advertisement. When the question arises, what about the testamentary angle?
See, testamentary is the ultimate.
Now, there I want to put one more question. In the whole exercise of testamentary procedure, you are ultimately giving the newspaper advertisement.
Yeah.
So, are we not substituting the testamentary procedure part? The main is of the newspaper advertisement. And that we are covering up by way of release deed.
See, you are asking two technical questions. There is a testamentary document, there is a release deed.
Yes.
आप testamentary document करेंगे तो बहुत अच्छा है. There is a law of the land. कई लोगों को testamentary document नहीं करना है. Testamentary document मतलब probate करना है, will है तो, नहीं तो आपको letter of administration लेना है या section certificate लेना है. किसी लोगों को नहीं करना है क्योंकि बहुत खर्चा होता है, time होता है. तो release deed करता है. Can the society accept the release deed? Answer is yes, and you proceed.
One question. Yeah. If the member is alive and he puts a release deed to the son or something like that, then
that's a gift deed.
During
your lifetime, you can gift your property, and once the person gets diseased, then release deed comes in picture.
Okay, if he gives a gift deed, then the son and the whoever is.
Once he gifts his property, then he has no right. In that case, the donee becomes a member of a society after making an application.
And there's no need of newspaper publication.
No, not in that case. Not in that case. The newspaper publication has to be done only when you are asking for provisional membership under 35, when there is no nomination made with the society.
But if there are other heirs, then he's only giving it to the son. If there's the daughter.
That is their internal dispute. If they have any issues, they can approach before the court. Usually, it is said that the gift deed, if you are not gifting to all the legal heirs, in that case, you need to make them as a confirming party. But if you don't make it, if they challenge it, they have to approach before the court. Not the society. Sorry? Yeah, in that case you have to pay the entrance fee of ₹100 and ₹500 for transfer fee. That's it. And when you are gifting the property or when you are transferring the property, in that case a premium amount of ₹25,000 is applicable. No, not the power of attorney. In case of election, the power of attorney has no right. All the rights vest with the member, the provisional member, and joint member and associate member. That's it. Now the next is rights and duties of member. No member shall be eligible for being appointed, nominated, elected, co-opted or become a member of a committee if he is a defaulter of a society. So if you are a defaulter of a society, you are not eligible to be a part of a managing committee. The associate member shall have a right to contest the election of a committee with a prior written consent of a member. This was what Sir had discussed. If the associate member wants to become a part of a managing committee, they need to give a written consent to the society. Now, what are the rights that the members have in a society? That is, a member shall be entitled to exercise the rights as provided in the Act. Every member has a right to vote. That is one thing. Yeah, now the additional rights, apart from right to vote and all those things, second thing is additional right of a member to inspect the documents laid down under section 154B8 of Maharashtra Cooperative Society. Under this section, there are certain documents which can be viewed by every member and can be asked from the society for inspection. So this are the act says about. Now other thing is right of a member to transfer his right title interest in the property under section 154B12 of Maharashtra Cooperative Society Act. You can gift your property or you can transfer, this is the right given to him. Now voting right, every member has a right to vote in the society. The vote shall be done personally, and in case of equality of votes, the chairman shall have a casting vote in the meeting. The provisional member shall have a right to vote. This is one important point. In case of a joint member, the person whose name stands first the share certificate shall have a right to vote. In the absence, the person whose name stands second and in the absence of both, the person whose name stands next and likewise and is present and is not a minor shall have a right to vote.
No letter will be required. Who said that no letter is required?
See, this is about the right to vote. Okay, this is the act. Procedure is given in the rules. So in the rules they have said, when we discuss about the election rule, how a joint member, how an associate member can vote is given in the rules. वो जब rules आएगा ना, lunch के बाद rules देखेंगे हम लोग, या नहीं तो 10 मिनट के बाद देखेंगे तब पता चलेगा आपको how final list of voter is prepared. Final list of voter is prepared after taking a letter of transfer of right of voting from joint member to the joint member or to the associate member. ठीक है? वो आपको बाद में मालूम है. ये right to vote है. But how to vote? Procedure is given in the rules.
The managing committee will submit the provisional list. Okay. Now, should the returning officer check whether all the members have been duly admitted or not?
Duly admitted as, sorry?
If he is a provisional member, whether he has been duly admitted, yeah, I see naam likh diya hai.
In this case, the returning officer has to recheck it with the INJ register. Final list jab aap prepare karte ho, us time pe aapko jo bhi objections aate, claims aate, you have to again recheck it with the INJ register.
Properly. Husband expired हो गया तो wife का नाम लिख दिया. So should the returning officer check all that?
He has to go through the documents. He has to check it.
Procedure has been followed or not?
He has to check those things.
ये जो voting right है ना जरा
In case of association of societies, authorized member of a society shall have a right to vote. In case of a company or firm or any other body, corporate or local authority or any other legal body constituted under any law for the time being in force, the authorized director or person or any one of the partners as appointed by the firm shall have a right to vote. This is in case of a company, any other director can vote, any authorized person can vote on behalf of the company.
Well, the question is,
in the case of a partnership firm, whether only partner has a right to vote or he can authorize his employee to vote?
Partner has a right to vote.
Anybody else? Any person.
Partner has a right to vote with the application provided by the partnership.
नहीं, सवाल ये है, जब भी वोटिंग के लिए आते हैं तो रिटर्निंग ऑफिसर हैज टू फाइनलाइज द वोटर लिस्ट. तो रिटर्निंग ऑफिसर ये नहीं बोलना चाहिए पार्टनरशिप फॉर्म है, आप पार्टनरशिप डीड लेके आओ और वो पार्टनरशिप डीड में कितने पार्टनर्स है, तीन पार्टनर है, आप वो तीन पार्टनर में से तो नहीं हो, इसके लिए मैं आपको मतदान का अधिकार नहीं दूंगा, ये नहीं होगा. यदि पार्टनरशिप फॉर्म का लेटर एड में we hereby authorize Mr. So-and-so, who is an employee of our firm, to vote, then that employee has entitlement to vote. Because the word used is any person. आप जरा इसके लिए पढ़ो, जरा.
In case of a company or firm or any other body, corporate or local authority or any legal body constituted under any law for the time being in force, the authorized director or person or any one of the partners as appointed by the firm shall have a right to vote.
Subject to board resolution.
As far as company is concerned, board resolution. Society is concerned, committee resolution. As far as partnership is concerned, any partner can authorize. On the letter, उधर तो resolution होता नहीं, समझ में आया? Partnership firm, on the letter of the partnership firm, they can authorize any person to vote. Then the returning officer has to admit them in the final list of voters. Correct.
So what about then if I have n number of partners in it?
No, bro. Any one partner is also sufficient because it is given on the partnership forms letter.
Apart from that,
देखो अभी इनका सवाल क्या है, 10 पार्टनर है, 10 लोगों ने 10 लेटर दे दिया अलग अलग आदमी का, फिर आपको बोलेगा आप 10 लोग जाओ रजिस्ट्रार के पास फाइल अप करके आओ, इफ देयर इज अ मैटर ऑफ डिस्प्यूट सर, वेट, आपको एक पार्टनरशिप फॉर्म का लेटर हेड में एक लेटर आ गया, ओके, यू एडमिट इन एज इन द फाइनल लिस्ट ऑफ वोटर्स। यदि डिस्प्यूट कब आएगा, यदि 4-5 एप्लीकेशन आएगा, कोई ऑब्जेक्शन लिया तो if there is somebody who is taking objection, then at that time you may say that since there are people who have taken objection, I will not consider this authority. That has to be decided by the returning officer at that time. Right now, if a firm on the letterhead authorizes a person to vote, he can vote. ठीक है?
Now, how can a person be admitted as joint member of society? In that case, the person has to give you the society form number 5, which has to be changed a little bit, because earlier it was for associate member, now it has to be given for joint member, along with the share transfer fee of rupees 100 and along with the entrance fee of rupees 100 and share transfer fee of 500. The associate member shall be admitted to the membership of housing society on written consent of the original member to exercise his rights and duties. The original member shall submit a no objection certificate undertaking in accordance to Appendix 10 of model bylaws to the associate member or a joint member intending to contest the election of a managing committee. If the joint member or the provisional member wishes to contest the election, in that case they have to submit form number 10A with the society, and after that, that person can contest the election in the society.
Yeah, but if there is only one provisional member, then?
One provisional member?
Only
for that particular election. Only for that particular election.
My understanding is that Appendix 5 is being used for attending AGM and Appendix 10A is for the purpose of election, like contesting, casting the vote. So is it correct or the.
No, 10A is used for.
5A is given when you want to admit the person as a joint member in the society. At that time, you have to give the 5, appendix number 5, and that is given. The name will be entered in the share certificate as a joint member. Once that is done, then 10 is different. 10 is for only for related to the elections. That's it.
Joint member, appendix 10 basis,
you only have a right to contest the election. With the permission of the original member. Yes, the 10A has to be given. 10A is with respect to the elections.
Why is membership document and 10A is contesting? Permission to contest.
If we elected, then original member does not interfere till 5 years.
If the joint member is elected or an associate member is elected, then the primary member shall not have any role for the next 5 years, till the person is in office.
The management of corporate
social finance.
We have our panel advocate and treasurer of Maharashtra Society's Welfare Association. He is advocate Naresh Pai. So let him take the next chapter. I think advocate Kiran got fired up with lot of questions. So somebody else should use the bullet. So, डेफिनेशन ऑफ वर्ड्स जनरल बॉडी का डेफिनेशन वगैरह दिया हुआ है, देन कमिटी मेंबर्स का डेफिनेशन, कमिटी का डेफिनेशन दिया हुआ है, कमिटी मेंबर्स का डेफिनेशन दिया है, इट इज इन चैप्टर 154 B13 में. देन जनरल मीटिंग क्या है उसका डेफिनेशन, देन फाइनल अथॉरिटी, सो जनरल बॉडी, या देन पावर्स एंड फंक्शंस ऑफ कमिटी एंड कमिटी मेंबर्स एज पर सेक्शन 73 ऑफ द महाराष्ट्र कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज एक्ट, सो ये प्रोविजन दिया हुआ है. देन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ कमिटी, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ कमिटी के बारे में दिया हुआ है, सो 154 B19, कमिटी शैल कंसिस्ट ऑफ सच नंबर ऑफ मेंबर्स as may be decided by the state government by notification. As of now, bylaw number 114 में दिया हुआ है कि constitution of committee का, and also in 154 B20 and 21. So there will be general category. Then the, 2 seats are reserved for the women and 3 seats are reserved for SC/ST/OBC and nomadic tribes. So then comes next, Parthaji. Number of committee shall consist of such number of members as may be decided by the state government by notification or special order from time to time. So the committee of the society shall stand constituted on the date of declaration of result of election to the committee by returning officer, where more than 2/3 of the committee members of the strength as may be decided by the registrar from time to time have been elected.
Now, let us understand committee. When the committee is constituted, is considered to be constituted, the committee shall stand constituted on the declaration of the result of the election to the committee by returning officer. Matlab, earlier, to constitute the committee, we had to go to the registrar. And the registrar used to constitute the committee. Under the new act, the committee constitution is also with the returning officer. Matlab, returning officer apna letterhead mein bolta hai ki these are the committees which have got elected, then that day the committee gets constituted. Are you with me now? Now the question arises, where, how he can constitute the committee? He can constitute the committee, वो committee constitution हुआ करके लिख के कब दे सकता है? जब more than 2/3 of the committee members are elected. कितना? अभी 2/3. अभी हम एक example देते हैं और समझने का कोशिश करते हैं. Let us assume in a society up to 100 members, जनरल कैटेगरी 6 चाहिए, वुमेन 2 चाहिए, SC/ST 1 चाहिए और OBC 1 चाहिए और स्पेशल बैकवर्ड क्लास दैट इज NT या नोमैडिक ट्राइब्स जो भी है वो 1 चाहिए, तो अपना टोटल स्ट्रेंथ कितना हो गया? 11, सॉरी 11. Now try to get the point. Now in a society, ये नहीं है, ये नहीं है, ये नहीं है, ये नहीं है. Women कोई आया नहीं है. SC/ST/OBC numeric tribe भी कोई आया नहीं. General category में सिर्फ 5 आदमी आ गए. ऐसा होता है कि नहीं? बहुत सारे सोसाइटी में होता है, क्योंकि जहां 8 ही मेंबर है तो क्या करेगा वो, तो अभी सिर्फ 5 लोग आए. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज 2/3 ऑफ हाउ मेनी शुड बी कंसीडर्ड इज 11 और शुड बी कंसीडर इट एज 6 और शुड बी कंसीडर 6+8 क्या होना चाहिए? 2/3 ऑफ व्हाट? 2/3 ऑफ 11. अच्छा, 2/3 ऑफ 11 होता है तो कितना होगा? 7 होना चाहिए. एनी फ्रैक्शन इज एडेड इनटू द नेक्स्ट नंबर, ठीक है? तो अभी 7 चाहिए. अभी कमिटी कॉन्स्टिट्यूट हुआ क्या?
नहीं.
कॉन्स्टिट्यूट नहीं हुआ तो अभी आप डिक्लेयर कर सकते हो क्या? ये पूरा गलत हुआ। क्यों गलत हुआ? इसके लिए गलत हुआ, आगे जाके आपको बताया जाएगा। इन द केस ऑफ ए हाउसिंग सोसाइटी, जरा समझने का कोशिश करें, इन द केस ऑफ ए हाउसिंग सोसाइटी इफ दीज कैंडिडेट्स आर नॉट देयर, the strength of the only general category will be considered. Now general category में 6 है, 6 का 2/3 मतलब कितना हो गया? 4. Now if there are more than 4 or more than 4, then you can declare them as constituted. Parda. वो मैं बाद में आता हूँ, वो बाद में आएंगे। पहला सवाल अपन वन बाय वन जाएंगे, बिकॉज देयर इज, दिस इज अ मोस्ट टेक्निकल क्वेश्चन एंड मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट टू डाइजेस्ट एंड अंडरस्टैंड। मैं आता हूँ ना, रिटर्न गाइडलाइन भी आता हूँ। नो, they will not come into the picture, because there was a question to me, in the case of women, can the male be accommodated? So you just remember, in the ladies compartment, whether you can get in. If no, then you cannot. Simple, आप दिमाग में डालो, ladies में compartment में जा सकता हूँ क्या? नहीं जा सकता हूँ। तो ये नहीं जा सकते, वुमेन को तो है ना बहुत एम्पावरमेंट इतना दिया है, वो जनरल कंपार्टमेंट में वुमेन आ सकती है क्या? आ सकती है ना, तो जनरल कंपार्टमेंट में वो आ सकती है, तो फिर उधर भी आ सकती है, उसको पूरा पावर दिया है। हाँ, विच कैटेगरी दे वांट टू अप्लाई, in the nomination form they have to say which category they want to apply. Now let me come back to the same question. Zara badao. The committee shall stand constituted on the date of declaration of result by returning officer, where more than 2/3 of the committee members stand, as may be decided by the result from time to have been elected. So if the women SC/ST and these are not vacated, jo general category hai, only that will be considered as a strength of the committee to be elected. This need not be elected. आप जरा समझ लो मैं क्या बोलना चाहता हूं। This is compulsory to be elected, but this need not be elected. Are you with me? हाँ, if somebody applies, as they can be given the liberty to apply and get it elected. अनअपोज्ड, अपोज्ड, अभी वुमेन में भी जा सकता है, ज्यादा आ सकता है। तो अगेन कमिंग टू द पॉइंट, मान लो वुमेन में दो जगह में से एक आया, एससी एसटी वगैरह में एक एक आ गया समझो, अभी क्या होगा? द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द कमिटी विल बी डिसाइडेड 6+1+1+1+1+1। नाउ द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द कमिटी विल बी 4+6=10, 10 से 2/3 मतलब कितना हो गया? 6 point, जो भी आएगा, so which means 7.
6.2
भी आएगा, yeah, any fraction will be added to the next number, है ना? ऐसे ही है शायद, I will reconfirm it later, but right now let us assume it is to be added. In that case, 7 should get elected. If 5 and 4 are getting elected, then it will be 9. Either 3 bhi ho gaya, 3+4 becomes 7, then you can say committee is constituted. Either 3 aya, or 1, 2, 3, 4 aya, toh kitna ho gaya? 7 ho gaya, required kitna hai? 7 hai. So it gets constituted.
स्ट्रेंथ के लिए जनरल शुड बी टेकन एज ए बेस. दिस इज ए ऑप्शनल विच इज गिवन लेटर. Partha, आर यू गेटिंग नाउ? इट इज क्लियर. विच इज गिवन इन एज ही हैज राइटली पॉइंटेड आउट 154B 2021 में दिया है, विच ही विल रीड लिटिल लेटर. सालतर कमिटी कॉन्स्टिट्यूट होना नहीं. द क्वेश्चन समजा कॉन्स्टिट्यूट झाला नाही तर काय होणार? तर तुम्हाला रजिस्ट्रारला कळवावं लागेल, रजिस्ट्रार ऍडमिनिस्ट्रेटरला नेमेल, त्याच्यानंतर परत निवडणूक होईल. लक्षात आलं?
व्हॉट इज द ड्युरेशन ऑफ अन ऍडमिनिस्ट्रेटर इन अ सोसायटी?
6 मंथ्स.